I'm becoming a huge advocate for belly putting, believe it or not, because belly putting is just conventional putting connected to the belly. There's three major things that are happening in belly putting that basically make it easier, and the first is that simply the putter's anchor to the body. Now, what does that mean from a conventional stroke? Well, if you're set up perfectly, we've defined already what a good setup is. If you're set up perfectly, a conventional stroke, the room for error is that the arms can move around a little bit, the putter can actually get offline, the hands can get a little bit active. So by anchoring the putter to the body, it simply stabilizes everything. So the setup should be the same, but because the putter's anchored to the body, the hands don't have the ability to move around during the stroke, so you have much better control of the path. So that's the first point. Now the second thing that happens in a conventional stroke, or that can happen in a conventional stroke, is that when players come through the ball, if they get a little tight in their hands, the tendency would be to open up their body where the shoulders actually get open, and that tends to make the putter open up where they cut across the golf ball, or they can even, because their shoulders open up, the path is now left. If they square the putter, they'll pull the putt. So path and face can get a little bit off in conventional putting. Now the interesting thing with belly putting, what happens is that once a player connects to their body, the tendency would be to stay much quieter so that the shoulders stay square and then the face of the putter squares up to the ball, and so they simply roll the ball straighter off the face. So it helps players if they tend to open up and cut across the ball to learn to stay square and hit square putts. The third aspect we want to talk about is your speed control. You see, in belly putting, speed control is really determined with a pendulum stroke, which is what all the great putters have. Whether it's conventional or belly putting, the great putters have pendulum strokes. Many amateurs struggle with what we call a signature backstroke. That means that the putter goes back the same distance on all putts. In a pendulum stroke, the distance of the backstroke varies on different putts because of the length. So anyway, a signature backstroke, let's give you an example. If you had a 10-inch backstroke, 10 to 12, on a 4-foot putt, your brain would tell you to slow the putter down. It's too much power. If you had a 10 to 12-inch backstroke on a 50-foot putt, your brain would tell you to speed up and hit it harder because you don't have enough power. So in a pendulum stroke, you should be varying the distance. So when you look at belly putting, what's happening, the putter is connected to the player's belly, like a pendulum, that's your fulcrum, and then the putter's actually traveling different distances on both sides, and that's how you're controlling your speed. So a short putt might look like this, and a long putt would look more like this. So that's what a pendulum stroke looks like. And so that's the great thing about belly putting. It's really helping people to understand that motion, which will help them with their speed. So in summary, there's three things we've talked about here where anchoring the putter can be a true advantage in your putting style. First is, you won't have a tendency to let your arms float during the stroke, which would could change the path of your putter or the face. The second is, you won't have a tendency to open up and cut across the golf ball, which is a big mistake that a lot of people make. And the third is, you can develop a pendulum stroke. So if you really want to try belly putting, there's three things that you could really improve from that. And if you give it a good try, you might find it's really going to help you improve your putting.